So within my role, my main responsibilities are to deliver the science for the projects I'm actually working on. If we do science and we don't tell anybody about it, then, you know, what's the point of doing it? So a lot of my role is engaging with the stakeholders, and that could be government through to the general public, to actually publicise what we do here at NOC and the science that we do. I'm Dr Ben Moat, and I work here at the National Oceanography Centre. So I'm a senior scientist here, and I go out on ships and I make observations or measurements within the ocean and relate that to our changing climate. I have a first degree in mathematics, and I have a PhD from the School of Engineering Sciences at the University of Southampton. So my normal working schedule when I'm here at the NOC is 37 hours a week. That's Monday to Friday. But when I'm at sea on expeditions, this can vary. So I can work either an 8-hour shift or one 12-hour shift during the day. And we work 7 days a week, and that's for up to 6 weeks. Well, my grandfather, uncles all went to sea, cousins and my father were fishermen. So I think I was destined really to go onto the ocean and do something. And also colleagues really inspired me, not just here at NOC, but also internationally. So I could see these scientists who led expeditions across the ocean, say from Africa all the way across to South America. And I thought I wanted to do that. Expeditions actually take a lot of planning, so they're like 2 years in the planning. And when we get there, if I'm actually in charge of the ship, of the expedition, I have plans so we can actually be very efficient. So at sea, we meet first thing in the morning, discuss with all different teams on the ship what we're going to do that day. But being a scientist, you know, you're continuously learning new things all the time. So it is never a dull job. So oceanography needs a whole host of staff from many different disciplines. So if you're good at maths or physics, biology, chemistry, engineers and technicians as well. And we also need computer programmers, because we run big mathematical models of the Earth system. So my advice would be to choose which of these subjects you enjoy and which you're good at, and basically go for it.